Hi all, welcome to Examshala. In this video, we are going to see some important news and articles of 24th of March, 2021. Before getting started, kindly do like, share, subscribe our channel on YouTube. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook and Telegram. Let's get to the main video. First news is about the raising figures, that is the unemployment rate. COVID-19 may, as we know that due to a massive lockdown for almost a 6 months period and dip in the economic demand leading to dip in the economic supply and disruption in the supply chain management led to a lot of job losses. In that also, the figures are showing that the workforce that joined after the lockdown, when the lockdown was taken over and things were starting to get normal, the workforce which was working currently on that lockdown included most number of males, and the number of females further degraded. That is, it worsened the cases, it worsened the status of employment of the female workforce in our country, which is implicable or which is actually determining the economic power, undermining the economic power, ability and sustainability of Indian women in the Indian society. Since they are not having jobs, so no money, so no financial security, and no financial security in this country in this 21st century. If somebody has no financial autonomy and security, he or she are having no say anywhere, either in the home, society, community, anywhere. And that is why this data shows that the female labor participation, especially during the COVID-19 lockdowns and after that, has been continuously dipped. And that is a challenge to the woman empowerment, woman entrepreneurship in our country. So this is a very important as well as sad news. We can use such data in the cases of impacts of pandemic on the society, how to recover. So when we are suggesting some measures, some plans to work out after COVID, okay, how to come out of the pandemic, so we should also include such points that these pandemics and these high job loss cycles affects women's the most in comparison to the men, because men are seen as a versatile in the society and they can opt for any job without any social conditions restriction, without any physical or health condition. Whereas for women to work in an environment, it should be safe, sound, hygienic, and that is why most of the entrepreneurs are facing it difficult, or rather they don't make any effort to give or to create a situation which is woman friendly in work. And that is why this case is being alarming in our society. And so as a society, if you want to grow, the growth of males and females should be at equal level to barge the gap of disparity. That is the difference between male and female. And it should be barged by how? By giving them economic stimulus, economic opportunity, economic say in the country, community, as well as society. Next news is a very jolly news. That is, as we know, initially the vaccination program was for 45 plus those who are having comorbidities. That is, they were having some previous cases of diseases and previous health affected conditions. But now, seeing the rapid increase in the COVID cases, the government had decided to allow all the persons over 45 to get vaccinated. They will be able to get vaccinated at their nearest primary health care center, that is PHC, or at private bodies, whichever is suitable. But still, people who are less than 45, we know that India is a youth country, and up to 35 years of age, we have nearly 40% of our population. And still a large chunk of population which is actually working will be left behind. So it is द करेंटली द नीड ऑफ द आवर इज टू इंक्लूड दोज ऑल्सो इफ नॉट इन PHC बट लेट देम इन द प्राइवेट बॉडीज ऑल्सो सो दैट द रेट ऑफ वैक्सीनेशन शुड इंक्रीज एंड स्पेशली वी शुड नॉट एम टू अचीव अ कंप्लीट ओवरऑल इन जनरल वैक्सीनेशन पर्पज रादर वी विल फोकस ऑन सम क्लस्टर एरियाज सम बिग सिटीज वेयर द केसेस आर राइजिंग दैट इज बी इट अहमदाबाद बॉम्बे भोपाल दिल्ली सच मेजर अर्बन सेंटर शुड बी कवर्ड इनिशियली सो दैट द स्प्रेड ऑफ द डिजीज इन दीज सेंटर्स कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड बिकॉज इफ यू सी द होल ऑल ओवर इंडिया मैप द केसेस आर राइजिंग इन द मोस्ट ऑफ द अर्बन एरियाज एंड दैट टू इन द टॉप सिटीज सो इफ यू कैन कंट्रोल इफ यू कैन वैक्सीनेट 100% ऑन एंड अबाउट 95% 80% इन दीज सिटीज दैट विल बी हेल्पफुल इन कंटेनिंग द वायरस फ्रॉम द वेरी ओन सोर्स So these major cities, major urban areas to be vaccinated with an aim of 80-85% and that will automatically stop the flow of virus from one city to another city and from another city to level 2 city, level 2 city to level 3 city and level 3 to villages, small towns and other states. So the focus of the government of the day should be to contain the cluster and to vaccinate all the people in those clusters, not to vaccinate all over India at a go. Yes. At a larger picture is our overall goal should be to vaccinate all of the Indians, but it should start by vaccinating those urban clusters which are more prone to these diseases and in which imposing lockdown will be a heavy economic loss. Now there are two newses based on the moratorium. You know that during the lockdown, the government or the RBI said to the banks not to charge the EMIs. So if persons are not able to pay their EMI, that is equated monthly installments of the banks, they will not be fined for this, and a 12 months or 6 month moratorium was given. Moratorium means they were allowed, a relaxation was given to not to pay the interest EMI till 6 months, and on that there will be no extra charge. If someone can pay, they can pay it. But if someone is not able to pay, so there will be a relaxation period of 6 months where no fine will be paid by the banks in order to not payment of non-payment of the EMI. But what happened is the money which was left was being compounded. That is, banks started charging the EMI plus the interest on the EMI also. So if a person were going for the moratorium, banks started to charge EMI plus interest on that remained EMI, that is a compound interest, interest on interest, and that is why it went to the cases in the court and the final decision came in. That is, moratorium will not be extended, but at the same time there should be prohibition from charging interest on the interest. So government cannot charge, or the banks cannot charge the interest on the EMI which were not paid or which was said to be not to paid during this COVID lockdown period as a kind of a moratorium. Okay. And furthermore, that there will be no extension. So it is a win-win situation for both bank as well as common people. And there is also important fact that up to 2 crores of EMI, the person who are having up to 2 crores of loans, their EMI in this moratorium period was to be helped, or the interest on these EMIs was to be paid by the central government. So this was a part of scheme. So there are three important points for the whole news is, first is, so there will be no extension in the moratorium. Moratorium means the relaxation time period for which the EMI, non-payment of EMI, will not be charged by the banks to the person. Secondly, there will be no interest on interest up to the 6 months. So the time has been already lapsed. So it was from March 2022, 6 months after that, that is near up to September, October 2020. So accordingly, the problem is, if the people are not paying the EMI, the problem of NPA, non-performing assets, are increasing. And with this increase in the non-performing assets, what is happening? Currently, there are total 7.5% of loan which are of NPA. That is, if 100 loans are given by the banks. Out of these 100, 7.5 loans are NPAs. NPAs mean non-performing asset. Those loans where interest are not coming up to a period of 90 days. So if people are not paying interest on the loan up to 90 days, that loan is considered as a non-performing asset. This non-performing asset is currently at 7.5%. Banks are in the fear that if we further allow the moratorium, what will happen is it will increase to 13.5%, which will be very much difficult for the bank as well as for the economic situation of the country. Next news is very important from the basis point of international relations with Sri Lanka. There is a body called UNHCR, United Nations High Commission on Rights of the Citizens. It is UNHCR, Citizenship Rights, Human Rights Commissions. In this body, a case was being propounded on Sri Lanka for committing atrocities on the Tamil separatist during the civil war. As you know, there was a group LTTE, Liberation of Tamil Tigers LM, who was fighting for the Tamil in Sri Lanka. So Sri Lankan government or the Sri Lankan people had a war with the local Tamils and the Sinhalese. Sinhalese are the majority tribe people in Sri Lanka and Tamils in the northern area. This is Sri Lanka. So in this area and in this area and this area, three areas are Tamil dominated areas. Tamil peoples who were taken by the Britishers there for coffee plantation, sugarcane plantation, tea plantation, and they got settled there. And all of the rest area is Sinhalese people. So there is an ethnic fight between Tamil and the Sinhalese, and which, since the Sinhalese are in majority, the government formed, there is a democracy, and the majority government started to neglect the Tamils, and that is why the Tamils started to fight, just as the Naxal problem in India. And during this, the Sri Lankan army, which was of majority Sinhalese, genocided, persecuted extremities on the Tamil peoples, and that is why there has been a case against the Sri Lanka in the Human Rights Commissions, okay, Human Rights Council body. On that resolution, there was a part of vote which India opted to remove out, not to vote, abstained. Abstained means not participating in the voting resolutions. China, Pakistan, Bangladesh voted against the resolution, that is in support of Sri Lanka, whereas other 22 voted in favor of resolution, that is against Sri Lanka. So China, Pakistan and Bangladesh supported Sri Lanka, others were against Sri Lanka, and India abstained, that is not take part in the voting. Why? Because we want to maintain a good relations with both Sri Lanka as well as Tamils. Because if we support the Sri Lankan government, that is they were not doing the atrocities against the Tamil people, then there is an election going in Tamil Nadu and Tamils are an important issue. So the central party or the ruling party will lose. Similarly, if we go against Sri Lanka, Sri Lanka is an ally. It will go towards China. That will be difficult. So seeing our both interests, that is interest of Tamils as well as interest of country as well as interest of political party, we started to abstain, that is not to take part. So we will not vote in favor of Sri Lanka, not vote against Sri Lanka, we will actually not take part. So this was a good key diplomacy by the Indian diplomats, and the results were local politics as well as we wanted to buy peace and justice. Next is the Nyay Yojana. It is a kind of a UPI Yojana or UBI. This is Universal Basic Income. Every person in this type of system, a group of persons are decided and they are giving money instead of the subsidies. As we know, government gives subsidies to many poor peoples, like in gas cylinder subsidy, ration subsidies, डीजल सब्सिडीज, फर्टिलाइजर्स, पेट्रोलियम फ्यूल, मेडिकल. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ गिविंग ऑल दिस सब्सिडीज, दिस न्याय योजना और द यूनिवर्सल बेसिक स्कीम सेज दैट यू गिव सम फिक्स्ड अमाउंट ऑफ मनी एंड लेट देम बाई वॉट दे वॉन्ट बिकॉज द नीड ऑफ डिफरेंट पीपल विल बी डिफरेंट एज पर देयर लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड्स, एज पर देयर एरियाज, एज पर देयर जोग्राफी, एज पर देयर सोसाइटी, एज पर देयर कल्चर, रिलीजन. सो वी कैन नॉट मेक अ वन स्कीम फॉर ऑल ऑफ द इंडियंस. Rather, we will give them money and they will purchase what they want. So instead of giving subsidies, give them money, make them financially viable and they will get whatever they want. This is the basic concept of universal basic income. But what are the problems in? So initially the subsidy had the problem because people or the government bureaucracies or red tapeism using faulty names, the subsidy was diverted to private bodies, private companies. Those who were the target beneficiaries were not able to get because of some network issues, sometimes paper issues, etc. So in order to check the corruption in subsidies, the flow in subsidies, universal basic income was introduced. But the problem in this is, this UBI scheme will use huge amount of money and it will be on the exchequer of India. That is the Consolidated Fund of India. How much amount of money? Think, if every person, near about 40,000 is to be given to every person, every household, how much money will be there? It will increase inflation also, because if everybody is having money, the price of the commodities will increase rapidly, and that is why the things will get costlier. So inflation will increase. And also, instead of making some important devices, important institutions, health institutions, educational institutions, infrastructure, road, the government will directly give money. So there will be no such infrastructural development, no development on the side of health, education, road, water supply, sewage supply, petroleum, fuels. So this UBI will lead to non-payment in the infrastructure development. So this Nyay Yojana is currently being used in Kerala, but Kerala is a small state in a different scenario. There it might have work, but this UBI scheme has its limits as well as benefits, so we should work them accordingly. Economic survey has also proposed that not to everybody, but the persons who are in the BPL, that is below poverty line level, should be given such kinds of scheme so that it will help them, and basically it should be given to the women of the house so that they can spend it judiciously, and it will be easier to curb the poverty, unemployment, as well as it will boost the financial inclusion. This UBI can be linked with Jandhan, Aadhaar, PAN, etc., and will include the financial inclusion in the body. So this is the Nyay scheme, which is currently present in the government of Kerala. Government has been doing this in the ruling Congress party, and this is an example of universal basic income. Recently, the Bihar government has passed a new military police bill where a special armed police force has been allowed to guard the industrial premises, that is based on the CISF, Central Industrial Security Force ki tarah hi, like the Central Industrial Security Forces, there will be a special armed police forces which will replace the Bihar military forces, and they have the power to arrest any person without the magistrative orders in order to secure that particular industrial premises, not everywhere. Okay, so in order to secure that industry and its premises, they can arrest anybody at any time without having the magistrate order, but after arrest they will be again taken to the court. So the work is only to protect the industrial environment and to take the prisoners and the persons to the local police stations, and they will be sent to the court, and then the regular criminal justice procedure will work within the 24 hours. But the opposition is saying that they might misuse it, setting up factories in the nearby areas of the opposition leaders, and they will imprison the opposition leaders in future. So it is their apprehensions. Based on this, there was a complete chaos in the Bihar Legislative Assembly. So this was a complete bill. Again the same, this has been the map we discussed yesterday, the Ken Betwa project. So it is a project linking द पन्ना टाइगर रिजर्व इन बुंदेलखंड रीजन, द वाटर विल बी ट्रांसफॉर्म फ्रॉम केन रिवर टूअर्ड द बेतवा रिवर विच इज़ इन ललितपुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश बुंदेलखंड टू हेल्प द वाटर शॉर्टेज प्रॉब्लम. सी दिस मैप एंड मेक इट. थैंक यू. हैव अ नाइस डे.